Yo, check this out. Check this out, man. So I get rid of the glitched block off. So no matter what, everything that comes back up here, a lot of it will get sent into this box. They'll get launched up here. Behind this wall is their path down to the amp. But that's fake. They're gonna get launched up here. Right? And then this pathway ties together nicely to there for the next set of launchers, and then boom, I push them right into my ramp amp skybridge, and then it's already taken care of. Like, I was building this and I'm like, now how do I bring them? And then I look right here and it's like fucking ramp amp skybridge. It's short enough, they shouldn't despawn. Nothing is over like 12 tiles long, so it should be good everywhere. So yeah, man, it's gonna be fucking 30 waves, same geyser. That's what we're going for. And it should be AFK, man. I should be able to stand in my AFK spot. Certain spawns or husks might despawn, but I don't know. We'll find out. I've tried something like this before, but not so good. I actually had it way over there. Tried to path them up by ramp, but you can't do that, man. They got to be on a straight, flat path. They won't volunteer to climb up a single set of stairs. They'll go down them, but they won't go up them. I should have just enough structures to do this. I gotta guess the impact here. This is gonna be four, and then five. Five should just hit him to that wall. Five. Four and four. I got two structures left. I'm just gonna put one tar pit here. And one tar pit. That's it. That's all. Just the one tar pit. I should have healing on this wall, but we'll see the damage done at the end of the, same thing. And I also don't know how far I need to make this roof. I know they can't throw from like right beside it. They'll try to path down, hopefully. Let's find out. Took a bunch of structures from my home base, so it might take damage, but I don't really care at the moment.
You know the drill. We have disabled the storm shield, which means there is no barrier between you and the hordes outside. Let's start the clock and see how long you survive an escalating storm front. The field manual says the simulation ends when any amplifier or storm shield computer is destroyed. Prepare for an attack from the east.
I got them using that geyser now too, a little bit. On wave one. So that's kind of fun. I never seen this before. You know what? I gotta do something to beach there. Because on the south side, we would have to wait until they climb all the way back up before they can get onto this thing. So what I'm gonna do, hopefully I can do it now. Is this. I'm gonna put a floor right here. Break this open and put a wall launcher there to push them back this way. something like that. What I even could do is just get rid of all that stuff and put in another full impact floor launcher here. That should work for now, just to get a couple of the husks from the south. What up, gangsters? Crazy. I can't believe I got the mini boss from ramp going into the geyser here. Oh shit. Flinger spot. Nice. You know what's weird? That they're not trying to like break the floors. You could put cones edited underneath a sky bridge. It doesn't have to be four tiles, I guess, to a corner point. They don't aggro the floor to get down. But if it was a ramp, if you edit it up like that, they will. So you can put all kinds of block off underneath a sky bridge. Oh yeah. defenders keep stealing my guns, man. And the ammo. So if a mini boss is coming from that side, you want him to go in between, say, a pillar right here. So you can put a full wall here. And then two things like that, and then he'll dance. But I don't have any structures. Yeah, it doesn't take anything to make a mini boss dance. Just like in a situation like this, you don't want him to go around and break the walls, so you just put like a block off here and then he'll dance right here. Just because he wants to get one target wall, and you know he comes from that side, so he'll always go here and dance. As soon as you lock him in between this spot, he'll just dance. It doesn't matter if it's an assassin amplifier either. If you can get him to go in between those pillars, he's gonna dance. Yeah, man, I just discovered that. You know, messing around with the beach amp, like, mid-game, with the mini-boss running around. I found that if you just put him in between two pillars, and with one target wall, he'll dance no matter what. Really good indo, bro. Damage and stall right. Let's see here. Score combat 457. On wave 5, I try to have zero damage. All guys are. Every single wave, every husk. The goal is to get them into this geyser, including Devil, and now as of today, Beach. Hopefully. Devil works. I just haven't even tested Beach yet, not once. The cool thing is they're one after the other, so.
We have a break in the action.
Yeah, man.
Coming soon. Prepare for an attack from the north.
Devil North isn't as geyser heavy, but the best fucking devil there is. We'll still get some in the geyser here. Yeah, things have changed a lot. lots of friendly competition and really smart builders, and people have been making things a lot more efficient, cheap. Let's see what happens with this flinger here. Last time he got flung up into the sky bridge and stayed up there, walked around in circles. Right into the trap. Perfect. So yeah, you see most of them are just walking to the north, getting launched out to the back, where there's a glitched block off, so they get stuck down there forever. And then some of the assassins should be taking the sky bridge this way, yeah. That's nice. Oh, thanks, dude. Yeah, I'm just testing Beach, really. See what I gotta do to make it better. Thanks for stopping by, brother. Yeah, so most of the there'll be nothing by the amp, but most of the husks are lingering around the shores and the beach area behind Devil. Few of them are making their way into the geyser here, using that geyser down there, the one behind it, and this one here. There's only a couple right now. Get right up in the action for this one and see everything that's happening.
We have a break in the action. Another wave coming soon. Prepare for an attack from the south.
Just as I feared, the south won't be as heavy as the east, because they have to go all the way back around. Most of them do. Anyways, we'll see how this works. He's not despawning. Is he here? No, he got launched way over. Look where he is. Oh no. Oh. Oh shit. How big is there? Okay, well, I can't have that happening. Let's see. Got him up here. They path him back here. Are they already in the geyser? Cool. So we know it works. They're not gonna despawn. The paths are short enough. I just gotta scrounge up a couple structures. What the fuck is that? How do you get up there? You son of a bitch. It works. It definitely works. They're pathing proper. Yeah, I just gotta take care of those flingers, man. That is bloody exciting. Yeah, for sure. I know I can get it. I'm hoping maybe I'm just gonna create a flinger spot so that like a Kirby style flinger spot. I think that'll solve it perfectly. And then for the other side, I don't know, I'll have to do the same thing, just reduce lobber shield and put a flinger spot so that they back up and stand there and just stay the fuck out the tunnels. You know what I'm saying? I think that makes the most sense. Nice. Proud of myself, man. Proud of myself. That was my first build and attempt from, like, my brain's interpretation of how I would do it. And then, as I was doing it, it just started working out perfectly. The way the layout is, the way I already have Rampamp connecting to it, just works fucking wonderfully. You can't just have one long path, they'll despawn for sure, but if you break it down to like 10-12 tiles distance, they'll walk it, man. 10-12 tiles, launch them over, repeat. It's gonna be expensive, but it's gonna be worth it.
drill. We're ready to expand again. When you're ready to start the fight, select Expand Shield from the Storm Shield console.
Okay. Break right here. It'd be really cool if it didn't break right here. Do I need these floors here? I don't think I do. That should stop them from falling into these boxes by keeping them tight to the high side of the ramp. They're less likely to bounce off and hit the floor and go into the block off like that. So, I'll just put these here. Yeah, so again, for the mini-boss, he just wants to hit this wall here. So as long as you can get him in between these pillars, we know he's coming from right there, he's going to walk right here. And then he's locked. That's all there is to it. You don't even need these two structures here. But just as an example, they're non-aggro structures. You can put them like here and they'll still act as a block-off. No. No. All that hard work, dude. Damn. Okay. So a 4 will be good here, and then a 3 and a 3. We overshot it a little bit last time. That's enough. Alright, I'm gonna play a game called Guess a Good Flinger Spot. I'm gonna see. Right here. Right here. cannot upgrade a building being edited. Oh, yeah. Maybe I should have moved it over to the left because the husks might be like, yo. I don't know. We'll see. I just gotta put one on this side somewhere. Like right here. Alright, this looks flinger safe. Really need a wall. I'll be back for Wave 7 to test that beast out.
another wave coming soon. Prepare for an attack from the north. wave coming soon. Prepare for an attack from the west. have a break in the action. Another wave coming soon. Prepare for an attack from the east. ready to expand again. When you're ready to start the fight, select Expand Shield from the Storm Shield console.
know the drill. We have disabled the storm shield, which means there is no barrier between you and the hordes outside. Let's start the clock and see how long you survive an escalating storm front. The field manual says the simulation ends when any amplifier or storm shield computer is destroyed. Prepare for an attack from the north. an attack from the east.
Stay away from that twist if I were you, soldier. Nasty business.
north. In the action. Another wave coming soon. Prepare for an attack from the west. break in the action. Another wave coming soon. Prepare for an attack from the south. Another wave coming soon. Prepare for an attack from the south. another wave coming soon. Prepare for an attack from the south.
Attack from the west.
have a break in the action. Another wave coming soon. Prepare for an attack from the east.
Like, the original beach is, like, already AFK, but I just want the challenge, you know what I mean? That way I get every wave going to the geyser.
ready to expand again. When you're ready to start the fight, select Expand Shield from the Storm Shield console.
to war games, soldier. I do not understand half of these dials and monitors, but it seems like you've got some strange stuff coming your way. In the world of this simulation, Smasher Husks are invincible. It's as terrifying as it sounds.
You know the drill. We have disabled the storm shield, which means there is no barrier between you and the hordes outside. Let's start the clock and see how long you survive an escalating storm front. The field manual says the simulation ends when any amplifier or storm shield computer is destroyed. Prepare for an attack from the north.
Thank you.
break in the action. Another wave coming soon. Prepare for an attack from the east.
I would stay away from that twister if I were you, soldier. Nasty business.
Thank you.
wave coming soon. Prepare for an attack from the west. A break in the action. Another wave coming soon. Prepare for an attack from the north. direction. Another wave coming soon. Prepare for an attack from the south. In the action. Another wave coming soon. Prepare for an attack from the south.